to speak publicly about his infidelity for the first time in 3 months. Will an apology, though, be enough for Tiger to rehab his image? We're joined by Rick Cerrone, former senior director of media relations for the New York Yankees, notably coaching former Yankee Jason Giambi during his steroid scandal, and Cooper Lawrence, psychologist and author of The Cult of Celebrity. Perfect guests for this segment. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning, Gretchen.
All right, Rick, so you had your share of problems with the Yankees where you had to be in charge of the media mm-hmm. and figure out how to attack it mm-hmm. with Jason Giambi. Mm-hmm. Is Tiger Woods doing the right thing today to take no questions and to just speak for 5 minutes?
No, he's not, because I think, Gretchen, what he has to do is he's got to be humble and he's got to be honest. He's got to be a person. He's got to come out on the other side of this problem he's had as a better person. Now, we'll see if that happens, but I think by orchestrating no questions, it just reeks of control.
Mm-hmm. Doesn't it smack of elitism, Cooper? Sort of the way in which he led his life before? And if anyone had an issue with Tiger, he was a great golfer, but if anyone had an issue, it was the fact that he was a bit of an elitist.
And he is, because this isn't Hugh Grant. This is somebody who's asking me to open my wallet and buy all these products that he's selling to me. He's an industry. He's responsible for people on the PGA Tour and all the vendors and everybody. This is more than just for his wife. This is an absolute industry that he's in charge of, and there's a lot of money involved, and he needs to come forth and actually speak in a very real way.
And speaking of his wife, I want to get your pulse on this morning. Will she be there? Will Elin be standing next to Tiger Woods at 11 a.m. Eastern time?
I don't think she will. I think she's more likely to be in the gathering of close associates and friends, which is just so silly. This thing, close associates, a pool, this has all the ambiance of an execution. I mean, it's just so, I don't think she'll be there. And I just think that PR people today, they take out this playbook and they say, what is the minimum thing we have to do to move on with our life? We'll make a statement, we'll say a few things, and then we'll be able to say, a la Mark McGuire, I've done it, I've talked about it, I'm moving on.
From the psychologist's perspective, will she be there? Will the wife be there?
They're always there, because the attitude is, why should I change my lifestyle because you screwed up? You know, I have all this money, I have these kids, I have this whole lifestyle that I'm accustomed to, and because you don't know what to do with this part of your body, you know, why should I be the one to change my lifestyle? That's why they stand by them.
Mm-hmm. But Rick, the bottom line is, if Tiger comes back to golf, eventually he's going to have to face the gallery.
You know, and that's not going to be a problem. This is not standing on the mound or in right field at Yankee Stadium. I mean, this is golf. Sure, he's going to get someone with a sign, someone's going to yell something. I think once he gets on the golf course, that's going to be his sanctuary, so to speak. I don't think that's going to be the problem. I think he was so close to getting through this. Just say, look, I've got something to say. I'll take your questions. I understand there's very few, if any, questions he can answer.
Right.
He doesn't even owe us the answers. He just owes the opportunity to ask the questions.
That's a fantastic point.
No, he
totally
owes us the answers.
No, but I think that's it.
He's asking me to open my wallet for him and let my husband watch him. It's the women, the ones who let our husbands go to golf and watch golf.
But he could at least open it up for questions and then say, I can't answer that, or I choose not to answer that. One quick way to finalize it. Ernie Els, another famous golfer, has come out and said, look, it's a selfish move for him today to have this press conference at the same time one of the sponsors that dumped him, Accenture, is starting their own golf tournament. What do you think about former players coming out, or current players, and saying they think Tiger Woods is selfish?
I think they should have an opinion. I think he is selfish. However, you know, how he does affects their next contract. So I think it's very important that he does step forward and people do like him again, because if the ratings are down, I'm not going to get a better contract. So it's going to be very important for him to do the right thing.
This is the most attention he's got Accenture. I mean, no one knew that this golf tournament was taking place. No one knew that Accenture was sponsoring a golf tournament. Now the whole world knows it. Accenture should be saying, wow, thank you, Tiger Woods.
Perfect timing. You're helping us.
Isn't that bizarre how it comes full circle? Rick Cerrone and Cooper Lawrence, fantastic debate. Thank you. Coming up next, they were two of the first men on the scene of that plane attack in Austin, Texas yesterday, helping to pull people to safety. We'll talk